New business, 2019 budget.
Mr. President, the board package has your proposed 2019 budget in it. Staff has been working on that for the last month. We feel like it's a pretty good budget. So upon your review, we would like to approve it. And that would set our budget for 2019. Questions I'll try to answer. All the staff managers were in on doing the budget, so if you have any questions, I'm sure we can answer your questions.
Motion to approve the budget as presented.
So moved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Is there any further discussion?
Yes. What is government services $50,000?
Government services is a line item that I was asked to put on there.
I'll take that. Government services is to stand up a government services program. The history of the water system, we've never put a request in front of the legislature. So this is a placeholder and not to exceed amount that would allow us to pursue alternative sources of funding to help offset some of the infrastructure costs. That $50,000 placeholder is a not to exceed direction, Richard, and it includes any and all travel association dues that might be required as a part of a government services program. And I don't anticipate reaching that level.
Shouldn't we do that as a on a per issue basis rather than just a flat $50,000? In other words, if we find a project, come for the budget for the project?
Well, I think we will still be tasked with approving individual expenditures, but you know, coming up with a budget, there's an estimated amount that's going to be needed for that type of stuff.
But $50,000 going from zero to $50,000—that's quite a leap, isn't it?
We've never had that type of program, and you know, we're hoping to be able to bring in some of those sources of revenue.
We tasked the CEO to go after these sources of revenue. If we don't have a budget to do so, then we're giving him a task without the resources to do it.
No, I would think that we would come up with you could still do the research from here and then say, hey, there's a project that we want to go to Tallahassee or Washington to get these allocated funds for travel.
Well, that's what we're doing now. We're allocating the funds for the year. If we don't have it now, then it's not in the budget. I understand what you're saying, case-by-case basis, but we will do that as it comes.
We're going to do it as a case-by-case basis, and the board is going to be actively involved in spending the $50,000.
We're going to have to prove the expenditures.
All of them are just the ones that get a certain amount.
But first off, you said it was not to exceed $50,000. It's a proposed budget. That's what we're dealing with. So. No money spent right now.
Mr. Chairman, knowing that one of the priorities of the board was to seek out alternative sources of funding, and we were pretty far along in the budget process, basically the idea was to have a not-to-exceed placeholder there. Any travel that would be required as a part of that would meet whatever guidelines are in place for the water system. Obviously, any of that is going to be expensed, but we will probably have easily eight or more requests of various different agencies at the state and federal level for funding that will require travel and support. The idea was to have a budget placeholder there to where we wouldn't have to come back to the board for every single item.
One other thing I would like to ask is, our bylaws say we're supposed to present this at the annual meeting.
Well, in the last 10 years, we've always done it in December.
So we're going to violate the bylaws again?
I don't think
so.
The bylaws have to do it. The bylaws right here.
I've got it. Article 9, Section 8.
year and audit with the books and accounts of the corporation by a competent certified public accountant. The report prepared by such accountant shall be submitted to the members of the corporation at their annual meeting together with a proposed budget for the ensuing year.
Together with the proposed budget. So we're going to approve the proposed budget right now, and then we're going to provide that to members at the annual meeting.
No, it would be a proposed budget at the annual meeting. If we approved it today, it would be an approved budget.
But it's still an approved proposed budget.
Is you waiting on this?
Look at it real quick.
Line 22, you got wages of 2.15 million on a proposed budget. So
I didn't write
really that up.
I didn't write the bylaws. I didn't write the bylaws.
Okay.
So when you were president and you had it approved, you were rocked too then, right?
I must have been.
Okay. Do the bylaws prohibit a budget being approved in December?
Well, number E said, yeah. I mean, it says that the proposed budget will be submitted at the annual meeting, which is in January. Anything before that would essentially violate that section. You
know. Does the bylaw say anything else about conducting the business?
And I think you continue to conduct business based on the prior budget. Pass it to the annual meeting.
What are you suggesting?
There's clearly a conflict in what's been going on. I'm not in favor of starting the year without a budget. That doesn't make sense.
Table a motion until the annual meeting.
I have a question about an item on the budget. If we can at least continue to discuss the proposed budget. There's a new item in line 35, software services and licenses for $98,900.
And Warren, you will take that. That's Is that a new?
Actually, that's not really a new line item, Mark. They split a line item right there. That at one time there was a line item that was just computer expense. Over the last few years, because the software we use has gone from a buy it, put it on a computer model to a annual subscription, that line item, and Barbara, you correct me, and Warren, you correct me if I'm wrong, that line item kind of got away from what its original intent was. So last year it was, I believe last year the title was computer expense, and this year it has been split into two to reflect. There's an expense related to hardware acquisition every year, but there is also a rather large expense that's much greater than that's ever been in the past that is related to those software costs.
So we're 2018, our projection was 106, and we're looking at 129, roughly.
In this past year, Mark, line item 34, computer expense. Mm-hmm. You see the approved budget was $100,000 there.
Right.
And it looks like if we take what was spent through October, divided by 10, multiplied by 12, the anticipation would be that the projected amount is $106,318.
Right.
That number right there has now been split. Now you'll see that 2019 proposed budget, line item 34, computer expense, is $30,460. That's hardware cost.
Right.
The line item below, which is $98,900, is that anticipated software cost for next year. Those two numbers were in that one line item in 2018. And again, Barbara and Torin, correct me if I'm wrong, but that's my understanding.
Okay. And it just seems to me software services and licenses at almost $100,000 seems like a lot of money.
It's more than just software for computers. Mm-hmm. It's actually licensing, I believe, for the Omni site, monitors that we have on some of the lift stations, the census.
Our SCADA equipment.
Some of the SCADA equipment.
Licenses, and there's per seat expenses, right?
Yes.
Okay. The, so many seats.
Also, the meters that are automatically read, you have to pay yearly for that, and that's expense to that account.
You also added in the cost of the website?
Yes.
Okay. So
I do not believe it's in that cost. I think that was SCADA.
The which one?
The website cost. Yes.
The annual is in that line item, I believe.
So the annual is there. There's also another cost that we'll pay them whenever we
can. It's capitalized. Yes. Right. Yes. Yeah. 1A.
Okay. That answers my question.
Mr. Chairman, if we could staff just have some clarification on if we're not going to move into the new fiscal year with a approved budget to work off of. The previous board action had approved additional positions that would be added. That we would not obviously know what the funding limitations would be or where we can move forward on that. There's ongoing bond issues that we're planning on immediately moving forward with those negotiations to give us the ability to satisfy the capital improvement projects that are included as part of the budget. We would not be able to move forward with that. How would you like us to proceed in the first month of the year?
I hate to interrupt you, but after look at section E under 9, the report prepared by the accountant shall be submitted to the members of the corporation at their annual meeting. Obviously, we've already done this audit, and as long as we provide it to the members of the corporation at the annual meeting, it doesn't. Then you could read on together with the proposed budget. It doesn't necessarily say that we can't go ahead and approve a budget. We just have to make sure that we have it prepared to present to the members by the annual meeting.
As a proposed budget or approved budget?
Well, it says proposed budget, but the proposed budget would be tonight, essentially, and then we would approve it and then give them the approved budget, but it'd be the proposed budget that we approved tonight. That's how I'm reading it, as far as that goes. As long as we present it to the members at the annual meeting, report prepared by the accountant, because we've already done the audit of the corporation. Obviously, we're not going to do an audit the day of the you know, and that's coupled with the proposed budget. So we give them the audit and the proposed budget that we've already approved, at, as long as we do it at the annual meeting. I'm confused now.
It is possible for a board to amend the budget at any time during the year, so I don't see why we can't go ahead and approve it.
Maybe we'll approve it as a way we do a temporary approval, then I can final approval at the annual meeting.
I'm okay with that. I just like to go into the year with the...
Allow them to operate.
The staff of this place to make sure that they have what they need going into in 2 weeks.
Is that the way, as long as that's the way everybody reads the bylaws, do it?
No, that's why he's there. That's what he said.
Okay.
Then we present
it in January. Proposed and approved.
I'm have a motion to approve as presented.
So moved.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye. We need a second.
Okay.
I'll second.
Okay. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
I think I'm going to stay out of this.
Are you opposed?
I'm just not voting on it. I'm having a thing.
Okay. Motion carried. Point check signer.
Motion to approve Rob Williamson and the check signer.
Second?
Second.
Further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carried.